Okay, friends, Bellman back. This time around, I'm gonna be getting the tonal snake rule. You know, from the creation club. Why? Because I think this weapon really looks awesome. And I know it has a real cool quest. Also because tonal snake rules, man. Right. That gun looks super beast. It does. Really love the design of this gun. And it's supposed to be based on, I think it's the pistol, the classic gun from the original Fallout. Anyway, if you take a look to my girl, she's supposed to be jiLL Valentine from Resident Evil universe. Kinda made her based on the original version of jiLL Valentine with the beret.
I got so many flavors of mayhem for sale.
Hey, Cricket.
Come on, come on. Get your guns here. Small booms, big booms. I got them all.
I'll take a look, sure.
Guns, guns, and more guns. Just for you.
And this is how I got the gun early. Before I even started the quest. As soon you install this, you know, creation club, Cricket's gonna sell this gun. And, well, we can see it in detail. Looks amazing. I really love the design of it. I think it looks a little bit cooler than the 10mm of Fallout 4. I mean, both looks great, but this one, I don't know. It just looks more awesome, I think. Yeah, it's a very great, unique looking gun, and it does more default damage than the, you know, the original 10mm from the game, from Fallout 4. Yeah, well, so she will be selling a lot of variety of Creation Club guns, like this legendary shotgun, and she also will sell you, you know, the anti-material rifle, so you can, you know, you can wait, every time you wait 2 days, she will sell you different varieties of it, and you can get a lot of mod parts from it. You don't really need to be gun nuts to upgrade your anti-material rifle, you see? This one right here has the suppress part. So yeah, man. I usually don't spend perks on gun nuts because I know I can always get the mod part from vendors. Anyway, next thing to do. Tonal snake rules, man. Listen to the faint radio signal. There we go.
What is it?
Other side's chained up.
Passing through cars is prohibited.
Got it.
Passing through cars is
nice. Can't open it from this end. Sweet. Yes.
So, here we find our first tunnel snake guy, and the good thing is that also they give you the unique outfit, you know, like the one that Butch give you in Fallout 3. I always like this outfit, it's really cool looking. I think they did a good job in this Fallout 4 version of it. Now, the only problem, the things that I hate, they said, yeah, when you put the outfit, it's one of those one piece. When you're trying to equip something like right arm, you see it goes unequipped. which I hate. I think it's stupid that is an issue for a lot of the outfits. Makes no sense why that had to happen. See, I'm gonna try right leg, and yeah, it goes away. No, even the legs works. I don't see why. I think it's just kind of a lazy design. Didn't bother to fix that, but anyway, it looks awesome, man. I like the style of it. It's pretty much a jumpsuit with a jacket on, but the jacket looks awesome. And he has a snake in the back. The logo of the tunnel snake. So he has some poison resistance. I guess that's good, and I guess it makes sense. But I don't know. I would prefer if he had the effects that has on Fallout 3 that boosts your melee damage. And I think he, I don't know. It should boost your guns. Anyway, I'm gonna have it on just for the sake of this video. Get off me, you shit. Yeah, I'm gonna do fully classic 10 mil pistol and the outfit for the rest of this video. Another one. Feel bad for these guys, man, that they end up like this. Tunnel snakes rules. Yeah.
Resident Evil.
Won't be able to pick this.
Ultimatum. So, this is a very unique variant of the classic pistol. Now, it looks very beautiful. It has a lot of great details in it. As you can see, also have an inscription there that says a bullet is worth 1,000 threats, and I have 12. I think that's what it says there. And you have a radiation icon right there. And when you read the other side, it has another one longer. I think it reads, be not afraid of any beast, no matter what the size. When danger threatens, will me, I shall see its demise. I think it's what it says. And it looks epic, it really does. I really don't like the legendary effect of it. It may kind of be a good legendary effect for killing humans or raiders, but Radiation kind of sucks. Now, if I compare the regular receiver that comes with the, you know, with default classic, it's just the same receiver. So the physical damage, it seems to be just the same if you compare it. Like, it comes slightly modified different. Would totally prefer if the legendary effect is something like explosive or bleed damage, wounding damage. That wouldn't be so much better anyway. This is Wally's footlocker.
Got it.
This is looping back. Now let's see about the upgrades of the gun. Okay, just went back to the base just to, at least just to display the upgrades that you can do to the gun. Cause I bet some people that doesn't have this Creation Club mod may be curious to see. Now keep in mind that my gun nuts it's you know, it's not even on rank 2 yet, and I don't have Gunslinger perk, and this is a character that's still very low level. We started this video and she was on level 1 talking about my jiLL Valentine. Yeah, I kinda like more the way the short ported barrel looks, cause the gun looks a little bit less ridiculous and it looks a little bit more reasonable, the size more believable. But either way, both look great. I just prefer the short, the look of the short scope, I mean barrel. I like the sharpshooter's grip. I could totally take the grip from the ultimate weapon and put it here, but Now, if you had that mod that you can enchant these guns with legendary effects, you know, you can turn these guns into a real masterpiece guns, man. Because, you know, by default, they are more damaging than the regular 10mm of Fallout 4. But they shoot just a little bit slower. But it doesn't matter because they still have a great shooting speed. The reflex sight kind of looks cool, but at the same time, I don't know, I find it kind of hard to aim with it, but I guess I'm going to put it just to display it. Now probably what I'm going to be doing soon is a montage video, and yes, you can also suppress the gun. Also, the Tono Snake outfit, it can be, you know, you can put the ballistic mod on it. So, just for the record, we should make them better now. It looks cool with the suppressor. I'm gonna be using one with the suppressor and the other one without it. I think the suppressor looks a little bit too big, which I don't know how I feel. Yeah, I honestly like more just the look of it like this, because it's already a beast looking gun, you know. Anyway, let's hunt some stuff. Thank you.
gone! Mindless human! Hey! You disappear! No fair! Where'd you go? Huh? Gonna find you? Gonna kill you! You're here! You're here! Stop hiding!
Hi.
That's a lot. Need to get back to Diamond City one of these days. Biggest town I ever saw.
Woo! Gotcha, didn't I? I ain't running out of ammo anytime soon! Take a lot more than some big fish to scare.